I'm Melissa Yarhoff from Okinawa, and I was a participant in 2008. I graduated in Naha Kokusai High School, and now I study at Waseda University. Today, I would like to share a few things I learned from Ayako and the experience here, and also what this experience inspired me to do. First, let me share one answer I received from this program. And when I discovered the answer, I was really happy, and I burst into tears at my speech at the program's ending ceremony. The answer was, though there are differences in race, nation, and values, since we are all born as human beings, we can definitely understand each other. Now, I have confidence that I will be able to connect to another person, no matter how different that person may be. If you grow up in Okinawa, you always see that tension between Okinawans and the military base. And my dad is American, and my mom is Japanese, so I always wondered why, I thought, you know, both sides are not that evil from my point of view. So I wondered why they're always in conflict, and why they cannot discuss this issue over together. And I also, in university, started to think about how Japan-Korea, Japan-China relations are also very tense. When I actually made some friends from Korea and China, they're actually really attractive, and I really became close to them. So it was very disappointing to see the countries in conflict with each other. Then I had the opportunity to participate in this program. For 3 weeks, we will be living together with high school students from all over Asia that you just met for the first time in your life. To be honest, I was very nervous, and I didn't know if I could make any friends at all. But it was the same for others as well. The first few days, we didn't speak a thing, only superficially. As days went by, and we started to introduce ourselves, did some activities together, discussed about our own countries and their cultures, and then we got to know that person. By the last day of the program, everyone was crying and embracing each other before returning to their home countries. Such an intimate relationship was formed in only 3 weeks. And I was stunned at how people from different backgrounds, different races, could come close together in such a short time. There are many different personalities and unique characters that you'll find when you meet people here. And we should look at those people through lens of nationality, right? When you get close to that person, seeing them as one unique individual, then you'll see how valuable they are. If we see each other only through the lenses of nationality, race, or culture, we can only find differences. To truly understand each other means to find a shared value or a similarity. What do you think a similarity is between human beings? I think it's love. And this is very obvious. But even if we can't communicate through language, we can always receive love. We can receive compassion. And I strongly realized this through this program. Before I went to study abroad, there was one thing that I learned. It was to love first. What does it mean to love first? It is to show interest and attention to the other person first. And it is to try to understand the other person first. Waiting for others to show interest to you and to talk to you or to understand you is not taking action first. I realized this strongly when I went abroad twice in high school and university. I went to the US in high school and I expected people there to be interested in me since I was a foreign exchange student. And I thought it would be easy to make friends there. But in reality, no one really showed interest in me, and they thought I was a local student in America. And then I realized I was only thinking of receiving something from them. I kept waiting for them to talk to me, to show interest. So even if I didn't have difficulties in English, I still couldn't make as many friends as I could. The exchange program that I went after learning to love first was different. I went to Singapore in university, and whenever I had time, I walked around campus and I tried to talk to people that I meet for the first time. Of course, it was very awkward, but I tried to challenge myself to get to know the person and to start a conversation. I trained myself in that way, so now I changed and I got out of my comfort zone. And now I truly became interested in talking to people for the first time and hopefully giving them something through this relationship that I formed with them. As you guys live together with those of different personalities and backgrounds, I hope that this 3 weeks for you will be a time to challenge yourself to love the other person first. Through Ayako, I gained a goal to establish true peace. By true peace, I mean peace in the heart. I'm especially determined to resolve the historical issues between Japan, Korea, and China. Right now, in order to make this happen, I am establishing a network together with some current students in my university and in other elite universities in Tokyo and China, Korea, Singapore, Taiwan, and also alumni from these universities. And this is to form a network of potential leaders in different branches in business, science, or politics to get to know each other at a younger age, like you guys, so that we can hopefully form a peaceful relationship in the future. The relationships that you'll build in these 3 weeks are very important when each of you become leaders in your country, especially in establishing peaceful diplomatic relationships among them in the future. The friendship you build here is a true one. Let me tell you just one last thing. Never forget that passion, that fire, and that purpose you have right now. After participating in this program and studying abroad, I was really interested in political and social issues in Okinawa, Japan, and the world. So I got into Waseda University. But I was very shocked to find nobody I could share my interests with. But most people were preoccupied with their own life. That's why they were interested in issues in the world. But I hope those who are here today, you are people who are conscious about your country, about Okinawa, about Japan, and about the world. And if you are, then you'll learn even deeply about what peace is, what international cooperation is through this program. And you are people who will become leaders, and peace is in your hands. So why not make this opportunity to challenge yourself and transform yourself? No matter how difficult the environment and situation becomes, don't lose that hope and that fire and that ambition you gained here. Hold on to it until the end. I hope all of you here will challenge yourself to make Okinawa, Japan, and your own country into a better and more ideal place. Thank you.